Now another important question, evaluate L of sine 2t cos 3t. L of the product sine 2t into cos 3t. See, I had seen in while checking the university answer papers, many of the students, they wrote wrong answers for this question. See, L of sine 2t into cos 3t, we cannot express this as L of sine 2t into L of cos 3t. You don't write this as a product of the Laplace transforms like that. See, we don't have that result. Okay, so when we have products of these types of trigonometric functions, sine cos, sine A cos B, you apply AB formulae. See, AB formulae says that whenever we have a product of trigonometric function, you can convert this product to a sum by using a formula. And we have totally four such formulae, and those four formulae collectively called AB formulae. You just go through AB formulae. See, the first formula, it says that 2 sine A cos B, 2 sine A cos B, this product can be converted to a sum. How? It is sine A plus B plus sine A minus B. You look at the angles, sine A and cos B, four different angles only you can apply AB formulae. If we have 2 sine A cos A, you don't write this formula. Okay. See, if we have different angles only, you can use this formula. So 2 sine A cos B, it is sine A plus B plus sine A minus B. And for this product, see, 2 cos A sine B, this product can be converted to the sum or the difference, like sine A plus B minus sine A minus B. Now the third formula, it is 2 cos A cos B. If we have a product like 2 cos A cos B, that is equal to cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. This is the corresponding sum formula. And the last formula, the fourth formula, 2 sin A sin B. This is very important. There is a slight difference in this formula. 2 sin A sin B is cos A minus B. See the first term, it is A minus B. In all the other three results, we have A plus B. It comes first, right? But in 2 sin A sin B, the first term is cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. These four formulae called AB formulae. Okay, so whenever you have a product like this, you convert this product to a sum by using AB formulae. So you have to learn these equations. Okay, now come back to this question. Here you have L of sine 2t into cos 3t. See, we have to convert this product to a sum. In the equation, we have 2 sine A cos B or 2 cos A sine B, but 2 is missing here. So what I did is, I multiplied this function by 2 and divided by the same 2. Okay? And I wrote this question as 1 by 2 into 2 cos 3t sine 2t. Cos 3t sine 2t. Okay? So cos 2 cos 3t sine 2t, this is of the form 2 cos A sine B. So by using the second formula, 2 cos A sine B, the product can be converted to 1 by 2 into, the term inside the bracket can be converted to sine A plus B, A plus B. A means 3t, B is 2t. So sine A plus B means sine 5t minus sine A minus B. This is A, this is B. So 3t minus 2t, it is sine t. See, you can use the first formula also, no problem. See, instead of using the second formula, you can use the first formula also, no problem. So here, 1 by 2 is a constant. You take out 1 by 2. Therefore, this is L of sine 5t minus L of sine t. Now, what is L of sine 5t? It is a by s square plus a square, and the value of a is 5. Okay, therefore 1 by 2 into 5 divided by s square plus 25 minus L of sin t. L of sin t. What is the value of a? A is 1. Therefore, 1 divided by s square plus 1. And if you want, you can further simplify this by taking s square plus 25 into s square plus 1 as the LCM, or you keep it same. So, this is the final answer of the given question, L of sin 2t into cos 3t. Okay, so whenever, remember once again, I'm telling you, whenever we have a product of these forms, you use AB formulae and convert the product to the corresponding sum, and for that sum, you calculate the Laplace transforms. Now you take the next example, L of 1 plus 2t divided by root t. See, this function is a rational function. That means a function of the form f by g. In this question, we are dividing each of these numerators by the denominator root t. Okay, so that we can split this to two functions. So, 1 by root t plus 2t divided by root t. Okay, now look at the first term. 1 by root t. Root t, we know it is t raised to half. Now take root t to the numerator. So it becomes t raised to minus half plus 2t divided by root t. T divided by root t, you have to simplify. T by root t is, t means it is t raised to 1. Root t means t raised to minus half. So t raised to 1 into t raised to minus half. This is of the form a raised to m into a raised to n, so that the powers can be added. So 1 minus 1 by 2, it is 1 by 2. Therefore the second term will be 2 into t raised to half. Okay, now we should find the Laplace transform of, that means L of t raised to minus half plus 2 times t raised to half. Now how do you proceed? You apply the linearity principle. That means you split this to two Laplace transforms. L of t raised to minus half plus L of 2t raised to half. Okay, so that we have there. L of t raised to minus half plus 2, since 2 is a constant, it can be taken outside, into L of t raised to half. Now what is the Laplace transform of t raised to minus half? See here, the power is minus half, right? The power is minus half. It is a fraction. So we can't apply the formula L of t raised to n is equal to n factorial by s raised to n plus 1. The factorial does not cannot be applicable. So in that case, you can use the second formula. See, I told you in the previous class, it is in terms of the gamma function. Okay, this is not square root. It is the division symbol. Just a division symbol. We can call it as gamma. So, gamma of n plus 1 divided by s raised to n plus 1. And this formula is applicable when n is any positive number. Okay, for n natural number, you can apply the definition in terms of the factorial. Okay, now you substitute n is equal to minus 1 by 2 in the formula. So, the first term, L of t raised to minus half is gamma of minus 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by s raised to minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus 2 into, now what is the Laplace transform of t raised to half? That is also the power is a fraction. Therefore, gamma of n plus 1, n is 1 by 2. So, gamma of 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by s raised to 1 by 2 plus 1. Okay. Therefore, this is, see, minus 1 by 2 plus 1, I'm simplifying, it is gamma of 1 by 2. This is not square root, it is gamma simple only. Gamma 1 by 2 divided by s raised to half plus 2 times gamma 3 by 2. See, 1 by 2 plus 1, it is 3 by 2. So, gamma 3 by 2 divided by s raised to 3 by 2. See, we can further simplify these two terms, gamma 1 by 2 and gamma 3 by 2. Okay, you can see how we can reduce this to or further simplification. Let us see the further simplification. Okay. So we have gamma 1 by 2 by s raised to 1 by 2 plus 2 times gamma 3 by 2 by s raised to 3 by 2. Now, our aim is to further simplify this. Okay. So here you have to learn two important results in gamma function. The first result says that the value of gamma 1 by 2 is equal to root pi. Okay, this is a result from the section, the details about gamma function. So there we have a result, gamma 1 by 2 is equal to root pi. So when you are applying this result, the first term gamma 1 by 2 by s raised to half becomes root pi divided by s raised to half. So whenever we have an expression like gamma 1 by 2, you can express this as root pi. Okay. Everywhere gamma 1 by 2 can be replaced by root pi. This is a result in gamma function. Okay. Now look at the next term. Gamma 3 by 2. What is the simplification? Gamma 3 by 2 can be simplified by using reduction formula in gamma function. And the reduction formula says that, see, this is the reduction formula, the second formula. Gamma n plus 1 is equal to n into gamma n. In the division symbol, the gamma symbol, we have n plus 1. You reduce n plus 1 to n, okay, into its gamma. So gamma n plus 1 is n into gamma n. By using this result, what is gamma 3 by 2? Gamma 3 by 2 will be seen. In the place of n plus 1, we have 3 by 2. So from 3 by 2, 1 less. That means 3 by 2 minus 1, right? It is 1 by 2. Into its gamma. Gamma 1 by 2. Okay. So gamma 3 by 2, the simplification is this 2 into gamma 3 by 2 simplification is 3 by 2 minus 1. That means 1 by 2 into its gamma. Gamma 1 by 2. So here this 2 and 2 get cancelled. We have gamma 1 by 2. Again use the result. Gamma 1 by 2. Whenever we have gamma 1 by 2, that can be replaced by root pi. Okay. So we have root pi divided by s raised to 3 by 2. S raised to 3 by 2. So, the step becomes root pi divided by s raised to half plus root pi divided by s raised to 3 by 2. Suppose when you are calculating, suppose we have instead of gamma 1 by 2, it is some gamma 1 by 4. We can't simplify. Okay, you keep it same, gamma 1 by 4 as it is. If it is gamma 1 by 3, you keep the gamma value of gamma 1 by 3 as it is. Okay, don't go for the next step. Only for gamma 1 by 2, you can replace this by root pi. Okay, keep in mind that. Therefore, see, root pi is a common factor. Therefore, root pi can be taken outside. This is root pi into 1 by s raised to half plus 1 by s raised to 3 by 2. And this is the final answer. Okay. So, I hope you all understood the Laplace transformation. Already we discussed the Laplace transformation, the definition and the 7 results. See, 7 standard functions whose Laplace transforms we considered, and we did only few questions. Okay. So, I think all of you understood what I discussed in this class. Thank you.